Welcome back, viewer, to Artistry. I'm your host, Tirus. Now, we're going to focus on safety, because safety is a very important feature in whatsoever we are doing. Whether you are driving, whether you are resting, whether you are working, whatever you are doing, you need to observe safety. And safety is such a wide topic. So for now, we are going to concentrate on the workshop related safety. And we're going to start with the personal safety. Personal safety meaning we have to concentrate on how do we look in the workshop. So as you see me here, I'm dressed now for the workshop. I am ready now to start working. And so the emphasis we put on, first of all, is on your dressing as well as your attitude. Your mind should be well set. And safety starts with your own self. You start with a right mind, a right attitude, and then you move now to what we can see, which is the clothing. Because if you come to the workshop and perhaps your mind is not settled, it's very easy to make or cause an accident, causing meaning even to a second party. So when you come to the workshop, make sure you are fully set for the activity in your mind, and then you enter the workshop. You have to be dressed in a way that you are not likely to get injured. So with me here, I have an apron. The apron I have is for working, and it is going to help me because it doesn't have very long sleeves. Actually, it's sleeveless. It's just an apron that I hang from my neck. And then it has a pocket where I fit my tape measure. I can put my pencil, those tools that I use and cannot harm me. I cannot put a chisel inside this pocket. A chisel is a sharp tool. As we saw, it has a sharp edge. And so once I put it in the pocket, it's likely just to cut the fabric, and then it's going to injure me. So to avoid injury and to be safe, we need to know how to use this pocket. Yes, it is availed in the at the design stage of this apron, but the right use of the pocket is to use it in a way that you will be safe. So the apron is very important to protect you from dust, as well as to help you work without minding so much of your outfit. And then from there, my shoes should be closed shoes. Once you come to the workshop to work, make sure you have closed shoes that will protect you from injury in case a tool falls. You'll be safe. And if possible, even the shoe that has a steel toe at the front could be much better even. So we also encourage the use of short sleeve shirts. But if I have to use this shirt that has a long sleeve, which most of us are used to wear, I have to roll it up. I'll have to roll it up so that I be safe in the workshop. So safety is very key and very important when we come to working in the workshop. So I'll roll my sleeves up so that I can have my hands ready for work. So once I roll up my sleeves, then it will be very convenient for me to work. So once I have my sleeves up, my closed shoes, I have my apron. In case I'm working in a noisy environment, there are some earmuffs that we also fit. In case you are working where your hands are at a risk, I can also fit gloves for the hands. So the workshop dressing is very important. Once you enter the workshop, then we must take care of the dressing that we do. We can't come with open shoes or slippers and start working in the workshop. The possibility of you getting hurt is very high. So we are going to start from there as we move now to the other part of safety. Now, on workshop safety, we have a set of workshop rules that you'll find in every workshop. Every workshop will have a set of rules just to remind you of what is expected of you in that workshop. Simply because when we come to the workshop, we are coming from home, we are coming from traveling, we are coming from the road, we come from different places where we don't observe safety to the extent, to that close extent. But in the workshop, the possibility of you being hurt by one of these tools or even power tools is very high. So to act as a reminder, we have a set of rules in the workshop where we remind the workshop users on the way to handle safety in the workshop. So on the on our workshop rules here, we talk about dressing appropriately for the workshop, wearing an apron or an overall, and safety boots. That one we have considered in the personal safety. Wash hands before and after work. This is simply because you may be working in the workshop and you have used the glue, you have touched on dirt of other kind, we have touched on some chemicals, and now we forget about our hands and move on to something else. So it is important for us to remind ourselves about the personal hygiene and washing our hands in the workshop before and after. Walk, do not run in the workshop. So that one, many accidents have happened when people are trying to rush and they fall or they hit other people, you fall on some tools. Walk, don't run in the workshop. Make sure your working place is clear. So if I'm working around here, I must make sure I have some space to work on, and then I should not have so many things clogged about where I'm working. Keep your bench tidy. That is to mean I cannot work on this bench when all these tools are here. I have to consider only the tools that I'm working with, then I use them as the others, I keep them aside. Return tools and equipment to the correct place immediately you have finished with them. So that means I'll just pick the tool I want, I use it, then I return it. Those are just part of the safety rules. We don't fool around also in the workshop. Needless shouting or whistling in the workshop may cause distraction to someone who is using perhaps a power tool, or even cause an unwarranted attention to people who are around the workshop or are also doing their duties. So close the vise when not in use. We saw the bench vise. When it's not in use, we close it. Once you leave it open, it can act as a barrier or even hit someone, because you are used to it being closed and then someone left it open. Remove oil, paint, or any other slippery substance in the floor. Immediately you are through with it. So store flammable liquids and in sealed containers away from heat or flames. So workshop fires can emanate from chemicals which are left carelessly in the floor, and a fire may just start from anywhere. So long pieces of timber should be carried by two persons at each end. So if you have a long piece of timber, it's advisable to have two people carry it instead of one person trying to carry it alone. And then you hit on other people, you hit on other items in the workshop. Store timber, parts of jobs and completed jobs away safely so that you will not fall. They will not fall. So finished products should be kept safe, and it should not cause an accident as well. Obtain permission to lift or move heavy objects. Keep your back straight, only bend your knees when lifting. That's an advice also for lifting heavy stuff. You fold your knee instead of your back. Your back is at a risk when you are lifting heavy objects. That's part of safety as well. Report any injury, no matter how minor it may be. So there are parts of these tools that can injure you, and then you end up having or getting an infection. So however minor it is, get some first aid on it, let it be treated, and you'll be safe. So report any illness that you may feel. Note the position of the fire extinguisher. We'll come to the fire extinguisher a while later. In case of fire, leave the workshop immediately in an orderly manner, because many people panic at the point that you see fire and you think it's uncontrollable. And we have so much wood here, you now think the whole building is down. So in a rush, trying to run, you may fall and get injured again. Then be alert. So report any conditions or acts which may be dangerous or may lead to an accident. So the workshop has many users. So if you suspect that someone is careless in the workshop, they may start a fire or something may happen to them and you also be at a risk, make sure you play safe. And then the hand tool safety, do not carry too many tools at once. Do not carry sharp edge or pointed tools in an apron pocket. Store tools in the tool cart or in the correct place. So there is the hand tool use. There is the workshop safety rule use, or rather rules. And we have the use of hand tools. Using hand tools, keep the job under control by holding it tightly or firmly under vice or cramps, so that both hands are free to guide the cutting tool. That one we discussed about it in the bench vice. You clamp your work and then you can either plane or cut or screw whatever you are doing. So there is the use of hand tools, there is the hand tool safety, there are also the workshop rules. But above all, the attitude in the workshop and also the environment, it should be conducive in such a way that you'll be able to work safely. The workshop should be well lit. It should have enough light. They should have enough air circulation. Once all these things are in place, the possibility of you having an accident in a workshop is very, very low. And we will always see that we have a safe working environment. So on safety, there are so many points that we can put together to make sure that we are safe. But most of all is to work sensibly and to know that safety touches on you, touches also on your neighbor, touches on someone else around the workshop, and also on the expensive power tools that we have. Incorrect use of these tools will also cause damages and losses. So we must take care of these tools for them to last longer and to serve us in the best way. So we have tools that that can go over a long time, but if wrongly handled, they will only go for a very short time. So we are going to look into safety even as we continue in doing all these other activities. We are going to consider safety, and we are going to have a safe working environment in the workshop. So for safety right now, we will go that far, but we will also get to the other part once we are set to work. So for now, we will go that far. We will get into the other part as we progress. But we are going to observe it as much as we are going to use it. So the last item on safety for now will be the fire extinguisher. So most of us know it, and it has a hose. So this one is for holding as you direct it to where the fire may be. In case of a fire breakage, then we just hit the top part of this, and then it releases the extinguishing component. For this one, it is a class A fire extinguisher, which will extinguish class A fires, which will comprise of wood, paper, and general stuff. So this is a very important piece of equipment available in all workshops. It's a requirement. So that in case of any fire outbreak, the occupants in the workshop should be able to use it to extinguish the fire. So for now, we'll go for a short break, then we'll get back. Stay tuned. Thank you.